In this question, you are given a linked list and asked to make a copy of it. But what is different about this linked list are these red lines, random pointers. Unlike every other linked list, which is just connected by the next pointers, nodes in this linked list have one other pointer called the random pointer, which points randomly to some other node in the linked list. Like the random pointer for node 1 points to node 3. You're asked to make a copy of this linked list along with the random pointers. So basically, you are asked to create another linked list in which has three nodes, and the first node, the random pointer of the first node, points to the third node, and so on. What makes this question challenging is the random pointers. If you ignore the red lines for a second, it's probably pretty trivial to make a copy of this linked list. So how do we go about making a copy of the linked list while preserving the random pointers? Let's see why these red lines are a problem in the first place. So if I just make a copy of the linked list, as you can see below, indicated by 1- 2- and 3-, how do I put in the random pointers? The random pointer for the first node points to the third node. So likewise, the random pointer for 1- must also point to 3-. One way is we can place pointers in this manner. Basically, we know that the random pointer for the first node points to the third node. So we could traverse this list and look for the third node and make this random pointer point to the third node. Then we move on to the second node. The random pointer for the second node points to the first node. So again, we traverse this list, look for the first node, and make the random pointer for the second node point to the first node. What would be the time complexity of this approach? For every node, we look up its random pointer. Say for node 1, we see that its random pointer is 3. So 1- random pointer should be 3-. And to look for 3-, we traverse through this list, look for 3-, and then assign the random pointer. So for every node, we spend O of n time complexity looking for the corresponding node with the corresponding random pointer node. So our total time complexity would be O of n square, because we do this O of n operation n times for each of the n nodes. Can we do better? What if we could find out that the counterpart node for node 3 is 3-, without having to traverse this list, if you could somehow directly find out the counterpart node for node 3, can we improve our time complexity? Obviously, yes, because we don't need to traverse this list. So pause this video for a minute and think about how you would go mapping a node with its counterpart node in the second list and avoid traversing this list for every node. One way to do that is using a hash table. For every node, we keep a mapping between the original node in this list, in the first list, and its counterpart nodes in the second list. So we use the hash table to map the node in the original list to a node in the original list. Basically, we are not storing the values, which will obviously be the same because the second list is the exact copy of the first list. We would map the address of node 1, basically this node, to this address, the address of this node here. So basically all that we are saying is, if you have node 1, this node is its counterpart node. If you give me this node, the address of this node, I'll give you the address of this node. And this way we can avoid traversing through this list looking for the third node. Likewise, if you give me this node, I will give you this node using the hash table. And you don't need to traverse this list looking for the corresponding node, the second node in this list. So once we have the hash table, it's pretty easy to assign the random pointers. We could just start with two pointers, one in the original list and one in the duplicate list. We can see that node 1's random pointer points to node 3. But now we don't need to traverse the duplicate list looking for the last node. 1's random pointer maps to the third node. So now again, obviously, in the duplicate list, 1' random pointer should also map to the third node of the duplicate list 3'. But to get to 3', note that I'm not traversing this list. Instead, I'm just going to go to this hash table and say, hey, give me the counterpart node for node 3, which is 3'. So now 1' random pointer has to point to 3', or basically the address that you get from the hash table. There you go. Now again, on both the lists, now we move on to 2 and 2'. 2's random pointer points to 1, but 1's counterpart node is 1', and the hash table gives us the address of 1'. So 2' random pointer can be assigned to 1' based on the address you get from the hash table. Likewise, node 3' random pointer will also be assigned to 2'. But do we really need the help of a hash table? Can we do without a hash table? So what were we using the hash table for? We were basically just using it to store the mapping between the nodes in the original list to the nodes in the duplicate list. In this figure here, as you can see, we still have the mapping between nodes in the original list to nodes in the duplicate list using the next pointers. Essentially, node 1's next pointer is 1', its counterpart node. Node 2's next pointer points to 2', its counterpart node. And how about the original list? Well, we have the original list preserved too. Essentially, the first, third, and fifth nodes of this list are the original list, while the second, fourth, and sixth node are the duplicate list. Now, we need to assign the random pointers for the nodes in even locations, for the nodes in second, fourth, and sixth locations, because those nodes don't yet have their random pointers assigned, obviously because they are the duplicate nodes. How do we go about doing this? We know that node 1's random pointer goes to node 3. Yes, node 1's random pointer goes to node 3. And from 1, we can easily get to 1', because 1's next points to 1'. And we also know that 1' random pointer should go to the counterpart of 3, which is 3'. But how do we get to 3'? 3' is nothing but 3's next. So from 1's random pointer, we got to 3. From 3's next, we got to 3'. And now we have a mapping from 1' to 3'. Likewise, we move our pointers. Now our pointers are at 2 and 2'. 2's random pointer takes us to 1. We need to look for the counterpart node of 1'. Although we don't have the hash table, 1's next gives us 1'. And now all that we need to do is assign 2' random pointer to 1'.
So basically, again, we have our pointers at 2 and 2 dash. We need to move each of these pointers 2 steps. So this would mean we have our pointers at 3 and 3 dash. Again, the first pointer at node 3 takes us to the random pointer of node 3, which is 2, and 2's next takes us to its counterpart node. The second pointer here, the pointer 3 dash, is the one that needs its random pointer to be assigned. And since we now have a pointer at 2 dash, we can assign this. So now we have the random pointers assigned for all the nodes. 1 dash has a random pointer assigned to 3 dash, 2 dash has a random pointer assigned to 1 dash, and so on. The only problem with this list is the original list and the duplicate list are both intertwined. Well, all that we need to do is we just need to split these two lists into two different lists, and that is easy to do because we can just ignore the random pointers and take out the nodes at the first, third, and fifth positions as the original list, and take out the nodes at the second, fourth, and sixth positions as the duplicate list. The random pointers are already assigned as they need to be. We can forget about the random pointers. So let us go ahead and split the list. There we go. We now have two different lists. And the copied list has the random pointers assigned as required. What would be the time complexity of this approach? Well, we created a duplicate list and inserted it in between the original list. That would take us O of n, because we need to traverse the original list, and we created a new node for every node in the original list. We then again traversed this list and assigned random pointers. For each node, it's a constant operation. There are n nodes, so that would take O of n. And lastly, we needed to separate the nodes, basically separating the nodes at the even and odd locations, and that would take O of n. So the total time complexity to do this is O of n, and we managed to do it without intermediate memory using a hash table.